Hello, Jester Good here, and today I'm reviewing a Lego Town Race set from 1995. It's called the Raven Racer. It has 61 pieces, one minifigure, and it retailed for $10 back in the day. Let's open this guy up since he's fully unopened and see what's inside. And you can see there's a whole bunch of pieces, some advertisements for some old sets, which I can't wait to take a look at, and of course, instruction booklets. So here's a drag racer with a nice torso print that isn't exclusive, but still pretty cool. And his helmet print is also not exclusive, but still really cool. He has a black visor and a very nice sunglassed face underneath. So both builds are simple town builds, and I didn't expect much more from this set, but still, it's nice to get this. And we got this nice dragster right here for the Raven Racer. I do like the black colors, which I guess is where the Raven name comes from. You can see there's some stickers actually on it, on the side right there that says 31. On this top part right here, which is a nice piece to get in black, and on this side right here. They also use some rarer pieces that I haven't seen so much, like this little wheel right here, which is used primarily in Technic sets, so that's why it was kind of a surprise to see here. Some older hinged pieces, which you don't see much of a use of today, including the stretcher wheels. And the whole design is just a really long kind of design, and it has a nice engine on the back, and you could, of course, sit one minifigure, which would be your racer, and he just kind of sits right there. He has a steering wheel to control the whole vehicle, and you could just push it along easily because it is on four wheels. And they give you all these tools, which are in an old gray color, and those are just held on this little tool rack. The instruction booklet is short, sweet, and simple, and the back shows some alternate builds, which are so nostalgic for me for their simple backgrounds. I love the little mountain and water designs. The three alternate builds they show are a tractor, a little bulldozer, and we have a little, it looks like a boat vehicle. So that's really neat, and it's cool how much creativity they got just from the simple racing build. And my favorite part is this little leaflet advertising some of the 1995 sets or around that era. We have this launch pad set, which is super classic for me. I think my cousin had that set. We have this racing speedway, which I haven't really seen before, really focused on. You can see that says 1996. There's also a plane coming out. There's this little auto transporter vehicle, this nice boat race kind of a waterway, which that's a pretty neat design. I don't remember seeing that before. And of course you got your police headquarters, which that's pretty nostalgic to me too. Somebody I know had that. And then you have this whole design for some of the race sets and all those 1996 sets as well. Very, very cool design. The back actually shows different themes. We have Aqua Zone. Ah, so cool. We got, I think that's, ooh, I don't remember which, I usually, is that Lion Knights? I want to say Lion Knights because they have lion designs, but I'm not so familiar with that one because, yeah, but it looks like it's a mix of Forestmen because they have the little sign right there. I don't know. And then we got Wild West. That is super nostalgic to me. I have a few of those, but they're all taken apart. We have this nice little pirate set. We're almost done with the Pirates line. It's actually one of the last years for Pirates. Explorians for space, and you have the boat line, of course, and then you got a Technic advertisement. So a whole bunch of sets on this one leaflet of paper. All those nostalgic advertisements and leaflets included in the set beside, the Raven Racer doesn't really stand out. It's just a Lego Town set that existed. Nice little dragster, you know, it'll be fun to play with. But it's not a set like Pizza to Go or even the McDonald's set that are really standouts for the whole town line. So you gotta keep that in mind. But hey, if you could get it cheap secondhand, which it seems like it's really cheap secondhand, it comes with some nice pieces, a very simple but good build, and yeah, pretty cool set. So that's it for now. Tell me what you guys think of this set, and I'll see you guys later on the next Throwback Thursday. Bye.